Hey guys, Sifu Jason here, Greenville Academy Martial Arts, and man, am I excited. I have brand new Hidden Wu. One of our guys, Devin, you've seen it before. He started this. This is the logo on his sleeve over here. You can Greenville Academy over here, and well done. One in the back. Link below. You can pick this stuff up, and it's just awesome. We're excited about it. It feels great too, man. It's good to move around with. Don't forget, like and subscribe this page. If you don't, if you're taking all this free material and you're not even liking and subscribing, I'm gonna tell on you. I'm gonna go tell John Wick that you slapped this dog. You don't wanna deal with that. So do the right things. Click like and subscribe. All right, the issue of the day is Jeet Kune Do. The primary attack is, you know, that long straight lead, that long quick jab, that great low side kick, and a kind of groin kick. But sometimes guys can get on you before you even get a chance to hit them. That can happen. To not have a rational fallback plan is literally the plan to fail. So what we want to have, again, is a rational plan that's a secondary that works for us without violating everything else we're doing. And here is the best thing for it, body shots. Now, Bruce had a way of training. He was a big fan of Jack Dempsey, who liked the body punch a lot, and he really likes something called the shovel hook. Now the shovel hook is a short range blow. It's just a beauty, it's a powerful shot, and it is so close range and so small a motion that it's very hard for non-trained fighters to ever hope to stop it, and it's very hard for even trained fighters to stop it. You don't see it as much today because gloves are bigger, and they've made those shots more difficult to get through. But let's get into it without further delay. Now, let's say, for example, the guy gets on me, right? He gets on me. So there is the first shovel. We call it a shovel because it's digging. Now, what's happening is my arm is not moving. It's not swinging too far. I'm not doing this. Not to say those hooks don't work. And don't count, they're beauties too. But the shovel hook is literally from right on top of this guy. I mean, my head is in his face, and that's what I'm doing. So I can headbutt him, I kind of accidentally head jab him. Now we consider head jabs to be a weapon here. There is a very renowned Jeet Kune Do instructor I work with a good while ago, over 30 years ago, and he's a big proponent of a headbutt. I call what he did, it does a head smash. I don't like doing that number, especially if a dude has a motorcycle helmet on, if you get the joke. But in this case, I think this is a good use of my head. I can stick it in his face, and if he, you know, if he's done up, has his head up, it's going to make life uncomfortable for him. But the real issue here is those shots. Now you notice I'm doing that. Now the idea with the shovel hook is that the arm stays against the body. It's literally scraping the paint off the ribs, as the old timers would say. It's literally a kind of a hip punch, shoulder punch. I'm not moving much. That's all I'm doing. And the fist turns slightly at impact. That's literally all I'm doing. So it's harder for somebody to get a hold of you, like an underhook or what have you, because you're not going like this. Now, if you are throwing hooks in conventional uppercuts, you do have to be more concerned with guys catching you for grappling and so forth. That's going to be more danger, more of a bigger danger for you than you would if you're doing shovel hooks. The idea with the shovel hook is that we're staying long and we're using our lead hand, lead foot, right? And maybe you can throw that cross, but watch what I'm going to do. Especially if you guys, JKD, you have your power, your right hand up front, that's very effective to step a little bit towards your right to open and fire that punch into the body as you go. It is hard to do because you're not doing this, and that's gonna be what you're gonna have to work with. So a good way to start it, you start using your rear hand first, because the front hand can be really hard if you don't have experience. But what I just did was, I sit here, and it's powered by the step, okay? I'm coming in, instead of really winging those shots, I'm doing this. And you'll be surprised, you can get about as much power from a really good shovel hook, even though it's only moving that far, as you can from a full open hook with more shoulder roll, because the nature of the hunch is driving in and it's just driving straight through the body. Just awesome shot. And it's so underused, especially if the guys try to grab you. If he tries to grab you, you hit him. We love the most basic expression, the most direct expression. Instead of trying to block, just trying to do anything else, he, you know, if I'm out here, I'm trying to stop hit him. I'm trying to get him out of here from here. But for some reason or another, he either gets a hold of me, grabs me, or, you know, he's just on top of me too fast. It can happen. So we have a good fallback plan. There it is. And my head is in position to headbutt him. I don't want to be like this. A, I could get headbutted, and B, I get nailed. So you have your head up, head down. And remember again, shoulder roll. Shoulders loose, and there's a slight boom. There's a snap with it. Because the arm moves, boom, but it's keeping the arm against the body as much as possible. Boom, and I'm not going like this, okay? That's just gonna get you tied up, easier for him to see coming, and even if you hit him, it's sort of like a ground rule double instead of a homer, because the anticipation allows the guy to move with it and get and deal with it better. Here, boom, 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 man, it's just so hard, especially if he's got his arms out. Ribcage, solar plexus, liver, bladder, whatever you can hit there. For every inch of shin, there's a foot of body. Hit the body, okay? So that is a great tactic and a great technique to use if for some reason the long stuff doesn't work. He breaks through. Remember, if we don't have a fallback plan, we have plan to fail, because that puts us in a position where we have to be perfect. You're still throwing straight hits. You're just throwing straight hits from a little bit of a different set. So yes, the JKD stance, long lead hand, lead foot, more fencing style footwork, and yet, here's where the boxing comes in. This is where you kind of get into your dagger game. You've got to use close range stuff, and the best way to do that is to attack the body, because most people are in here are trying to grab. If they bring those arms up, bam, 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 try to break those ribs, man. Bare knuckle against those ribs is really nasty. If he's not used to taking body shots, then he's probably going to be toast. He's probably going to be toast. That's the key to the whole thing. So definitely practice that. And a really good way to do it, again, is not to try too hard. If you try too hard, you'll start doing that number, and you're not going to be powerful. Plus, again, I'm not trying to go up. I'm going in. All right, so there you go. Shovel hooks, body shots. Do hope it helps. Go again, unless I get a call my good buddy John Wick and tell him about what you did to his dog. Click the like and subscribe, and check out Devin's wonderful and amazing Hidden Wu. Where? Hidden Wu. Wuso. I don't know why I named it that. I have no idea. He didn't consult me. I'd have called it Hidden Sifu Jason or something like that. That's probably too vain though, right? All right, jokes aside, catch you guys next time.
So here.
And then,
right.
Got it.
All it does is create space for this to thread through. See, you're trying to make this do all the work.
I am.
Make that do the work.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's bunk out.
Got it.
I beat your tongue.
Oh.
Dang it. Yep.
Got it.